Hi, it's Theo from Apify again, and in this video I'm going to introduce you to Apify's code templates, which lets you set up your web scraping or automation project in no time. Let's begin by navigating to the Actors page in Apify console, then click on the Create an Actor button. You will land on the new Actors page. As you can see, there are two other ways to create actors with Apify. One way is to use existing code from a Git repository. To find out more about that, check out our tutorial on building scrapers with GitHub. The other way is to create it via the Apify CLI. In this video, we'll only be showing you the first way, which is to create them via our web code templates. You can find the range of templates for three programming languages, Python, JavaScript, and TypeScript, and different library combinations. Click on View All Templates to see more options. We're going to use a Start template. If you're only just starting with web scraping or want to test out the Apify platform with a ready-to-use codebase, starter templates are made for you. After a minimal number of changes, you'll be able to extract data from any website. Let's click on the Start with Python template. The code here provides all the important information you need before you start creating the actor. You can find more information on the rest of the page, such as included features, use cases of the template, code previews, and instructions on what the code does. Once again, you have the option to use a template to create an actor via the Apify CLI, but we're only going to focus on the Web IDE in this tutorial. After clicking Use this template, you'll land in the actor's main file by default, where you can go through the code and adjust it to your specifications. When you create an actor, it will be given the default name, My Actor. If you have more actors named exactly the same way, it'll add a number to it. You can, of course, change the name by clicking on it. If you want to fork the actor, say to test new features in your code, you can do that easily by clicking the Fork button. You can also label specific versions of your actor, and of course, you can easily delete an actor version at any point. Check out the Tips button if you need any guidance on overcoming any issues you may be encountering while using the Web IDE. Note if you click on the Useful Links option, you'll be taken to the Apify documentation, where you can learn about developing actors in more depth. The most important files, main logic, can be found in the source, src folder. This is where the main actor file is located. The .actor folder is where we have the input schema and the actor.json file. That's where you can set information such as the actor's name, versions, build tag, and environment variables. The input schema JSON file defines the input of the actor, which is displayed and which you can fill in the input tab. If you make changes in the main file and it corresponds with what you're scraping, be aware that the changes should be made in all relevant files. You can find out more about that in the Adding Your Own Code tip. Before you can run your actor, you need to build it, so click the Build button. Once the build is finished, you can configure the actor via the Input tab. In this example, we're going to scrape apify.com, which is the default value for this template. Of course, you can change the URL in the input to get data from any website you like. Now you can click Start to run the actor. To see information about the last build and last run, go to the respective tabs. Here you can also see information on the cost of the run and build. Once the run is finished, you can export the results in multiple formats. Let's preview our results in JSON. The Web IDE should give you a solid understanding of how Apify works while showing you the most important functionalities. This is a great first step to scraping. If you prefer a local environment, you can use our pull commands for the specific actor version. This should make your development cycles faster, but we'll cover that in another video. That's all for this tutorial. Please do go ahead and give our templates a try and let us know in the comments how it went. We love hearing about interesting use cases, so if you have a project that you want to use our templates for or have any questions about creating your own actors, let us know. Also, don't forget to like, subscribe, and click the bell to keep up with future content. So long, and thanks for all the likes.